Hey guys, sorry about that. Didn't realize that my mic was turned off for a second there. Hey, welcome to the channel. This is Hindu Jr. And this is episode 10 of Pokemon XD Gale of Darkness. Now, I just fought the guy that was up here and got to this heal spot, which is nice. Kind of gives us a little bit to work with. I'm actually looking at pretty much my full team right here. I'm just one Pokemon short. And until I get to a point where I find a Pokemon that I actually want to hold on to, I'll have Teddy Ursa hang out with this team. I'm not really going to focus on Teddy Ursa. We'll see what I find. But I'm pretty sure I'll eventually run into something that I want. Probably, well, no, Curlia is, it is a catchable one, I think. Or was it Gardevoir? It's somewhere in that line I can catch that Pokemon, I think. But I have Baltoy, so kind of pointless. I don't know. I still have to get a grass type. I could probably fill that in. Or a steel. We'll see how that plays out. I'm not so sure how that's going to go. So, alright. Hi! Huh? Well, if it isn't a tiny little intruder with a monstrous set of Pokemon on his side, so good luck. You're gonna need it. Snorunt and Barboach. Okay, then. I was gonna say, don't crash. I don't need you crashing on me. Alright, so I don't want to do this. Mud Slap? Is that effective against ice types? I can't remember. You know what? I'm just going to go Shadow Wave. And I'm going to do Bite on Snorunt. Hopefully we can just take out Snorunt. Because that's the one that's honestly kind of scaring me. Barboach is just durable. It's not really got a whole lot going for it. Mud Sport, not like that's gonna make a difference. Well, okay then. My defenses have fallen. Cool. And aw, you piece of crap. Alright. Let's go Shadow Wave again. And let's actually go with Bite on Barboach. Hopefully this weakens it enough to where Shadow Wave will take both Pokemon out. Or it'll just take out Barboach. That's cool too. Alright then. That works. And Umbreon is now level 19. Yay. 3 to defense, 2 to special defense. Alright. That's cool. Alright. So, defense is behind. It, I think, will always be behind, but it's not exactly horrible. Oh, that was a critical hit of 15 points. That's kind of sad. And there it goes. Bye. Alright. Level 19. There's nothing cute about you, brat. Well, yeah, pretty much. Umbreon is cute, I think, anyway. Shit. But no, nothing cute about me in any way, shape, or form. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and swap out Baltoy. Or swap out Umbreon for Baltoy. Sorry. Let him get some experience. So, it's got some good moves. We'll see how they work. 80 accuracy, Rock Tomb. I'm not too impressed with Rock Tomb. I'm not too impressed with Psybeam's alright, I guess. I think Psywave is the one that I was thinking of. The one that's basically does a random amount of damage. It just, yeah, no, it's a crap move for Psychic, but Psybeam's okay. It's better than Confusion, worse than Psychic, basically. So that's fine. Mudslap's just, it's basically Sand Attack with a little bit of power behind it, so. Alright, let's see how that one goes. Let's go ahead and save. Just because I want to make sure I don't have to repeat a bunch of crap again. Oh, you know what? I think this is... three super potions. Cool. Alright, I don't think I want to continue going this route. I'm not positive, but I think... that continues on up. I could be wrong. I could fight that guy and figure it out, but... oh? Oh! Cool. Alright. I'll go ahead and make the trek. Why not? I could use another non-shadow Pokemon to train. Or to fight with, I should say. There is a way I could go about it to get out of here a little quicker, but... it would involve a lot of fights, I think. I'm not positive. And I don't want to take the chance, so... let's switch out Sfeel for Mareep. Alright. And I do understand that just because I don't want two psychic types, I do have two ground types, but one of them's a fire type, and I need a fire type of some kind. It was either having Numel around, or it was going to be Houndour. So, or Houndoom. Houndour. I think it's Houndour. But, yeah, I was going to have doubles somewhere in there. And unfortunately, I'm just going to have to deal with the fact that Numble is going to be my double for a second. Once I find a decent, come on, fire type that I can use, I will swap out Numble. But until then, I'm kind of stuck with Numble as my fire type. Hopefully it doesn't take too long. I don't think it'll be too much longer, but I'm not sure. And I suppose I could always just trade out Baltoy for Gardevoir. Just so that I can drop the ground type in some way, shape, or form. But I want to use Baltoy and ultimately its evolution. Just because I think they look cool and I've never really had the chance to play with them on my team. Lag. Regain the moves Aurora Beam. Nice. So I have an ice type move, along with a water move and a ground move, and Charm, which would drop opponent's attack. It's okay. 2,064 experience. So it's probably going to gain at least a level, if not two. So level 18. 3 to health, 1 to everything else. Just not great. Oh, dang it. I knew that was going to happen. Oh, I should have known better. I should have saved before I did that. Okay, come on. Alright, let me just go ahead and restart the whole thing. Okay, come on. There we go. Yeah, that's better. Sorry about that. My computer is not complying with what I want, even though we should know better. All right. Let's try and get through this again. Yes, yes. Come on. Yeah, I hope you guys are enjoying this, because this is really driving me nuts. I kind of figure I might as well leave it in, just so that you can see how much I am suffering through this, just to do this. The sad thing is, I still am enjoying playing the game when it's complying like it should. But at least I don't have to go through the whole Cipher lab again. But I still should have saved before I actually went through the process of purifying Sphiel, because I knew that was going to happen. I knew it was. It was just a matter of time. And my idiot self decided, ah, no, it's good. I'm good. I shouldn't have any problems with this. And then I have problems with it. So, yeah. Let's actually... I just noticed that the music is really quiet with this. Yeah, there we go. Are you kidding me? Wow! I left you for a half a freaking second and you go and die again. Like I said, I hope you guys are enjoying this. Again, I am enjoying it myself. It's kind of funny when it happens, and usually I'm not too far set back by it because of my habitual saving that has been procured because of how much this crash is. But still, it still gets on my nerves. Alright, let's try this one more time. I might just have to go ahead and save the second I get to a gate village. And then save again before I... I don't like how often I have to save, but it's kind of funny seeing as how I used to not be that type of a player. I used to always be... God damn, that is quiet. Why is that so far down? Oh well. But I used to not be nearly that kind of a saver. I was the guy that, you know, saved when I was done with the game. That was it. I had no problems going the entire round of gaming without touching the save option once. Until I was done with the game. But now, I'm starting to feel like I oversave sometimes. Just because I'm worried that the game is going to crash every other second. So, yeah, it's interesting. This is definitely a different feel for me. The lag. I hope my voice is coming through just fine, because it would be weird hearing it be all craggly like that. Yes, yes, come on. Let's go. Speed it up a little bit. I'm worried you're gonna freeze again. Yes, yes. This is about where I got last time. Alright, level's the same. Still. Special attack and defense looked okay. Level 19. 2 to HP, 2 to special defense, and 2 to defense. 1 to everything else. Yeah, so it's a special attacker with some decent defenses. That's actually kind of impressive. I like that setup. A bulky special attacker. I can work with that. Ooh, body slam. Yes. So, we have mud slap for ground, water gun for water, aurora beam for ice. I don't see much of a use for charm. I've never been much for, you know, lowering my opponent's stats. I just focus on beating the crap out of them. We'll see if that ends up biting me in the butt later or not. So we'll go ahead and drop charm. I've never really been in a situation where I've had to drop opponent's stats to increase my chances of winning. Learned body slam. The ribbon for being purified. No. Alright. Save again, because I don't want to have to go through that slugfest of lag again. Thank you. So, yeah. Sveal is now level 19. So, we're all good there. Alright. Now we can head back to the Sifra Lair. Where are these two at? You're actually really close to being purified already, and I haven't even involved you in a fight yet. I've just been walking around with you. I might just leave it like that, because Numel is nowhere near that. Yeah, we'll do this. Just because Maryp is already close to getting that level up, or getting that purification point as it is, I might as well just leave it as it is. And Numel has quite a bit to go before he's purified, on top of the fact that he's also the lowest level Pokemon on my team. So he's going to need all the experience that he can get, so that when he purifies, he'll get the levels he needs and he'll be a little more up to snuff with everyone else. So, let's go back to the Sifra Lab. And I think I want to figure out my way around the lab so that I have the quick way already open, so that I don't have to worry about fighting through a bunch of Pokemon or a bunch of trainer battles right at the end when I'm trying to leave. So, it's a long way I've got to go. I'm going to be saving at random intervals just so that I don't have to go through them again, because I am now paranoid thanks to this game. Yay. Who says trauma isn't a good thing to have? Trauma is what made me into becoming a save maniac. I'm not so sure if I should be happy about that. Alright, let's search the southern end of this. Let's go ahead and save one more time, just so that I don't have to worry about that. There we go. Alright, so, yeah, hi. Hello, little boy. Have you lost your way? Notu and Incada. Alright. Numel and Ballpoy. My two ground types. Alright, so, let's see here. Oh, Numel can already use Dig. That doesn't really help me a whole lot. Let's do Shadow Blitz on Notu. Oh, wait, no. Let's do Shadow Blitz on Insada, and then do Rock Tomb on Notu. Let's hope Rock Tomb hits. Alright, cool. Yeah, it's not gonna do a whole lot of damage, but Nightshade, oh yay. That's not gonna do a whole lot of damage. That did more than I was thinking it would do. But it fits. That might be okay. That probably would have been effective against Baltoy, if not just neutral damage, but good to see that it worked like that. Do Rock Tomb one more time. There we go. Cool. And that's not too out of the way. Okay, yeah, I did do some. Okay. So, Wailmer. You're gonna be a problem. Hopefully, Psybeam can do enough damage and take it out, but oh boy. Crap. I don't like that that did that, but oh well. Hopefully Psybeam, I mean, it has better accuracy, so it should hit. Problem is, Wailmer is a, he's a bulky boy. So Wailmer might be able to take a Psybeam. And he does. Crap. Alright. Oh, and now you're gonna growl. That's just great. So both of our attacks fell. Awesome. This is looking to be a stall fest. I don't think she's going to be able to do any major damage. I mean, the most damage she's done is 16 points to Numel, which honestly was very effective. And now I'm worried that Wailmer might end up using... actually, if Wailmer ends up doing any kind of water damage to either of them, they're both screwed. So let's try and focus on Wailmer. Hopefully it's a... good enough to take Wailmer out, and it should, so long as, ah, crap. Well, who's going down? Oof, alright, cool. So because he used it on Baltoy, he was able to pull through. Good job, Baltoy. I honestly wasn't expecting Baltoy to live, so good job on that. Whoo! And then Scratch just about takes out Baltoy too. But now it's just Ninsada, so I'm not too worried about that. Psybeam should be able to take it out. There we go. And now that fight is done. Some close calls there. I mean, how dare you? I mean, really. It's not like I'm playing a Nuzlocke. I'm not so sure that I honestly could play a Nuzlocke. It just, it's not my style. And I'm not so sure that I'm smart enough to actually pull it off. But if I was, I'd be looking all right as it is. Alright, there we go. Now we can go back down and progress through the story a little more. Maybe. Probably just to pick up that treasure chest that I just saw, which is in this direction. Hi. And ether. Again, I'm probably never going to use that, but cool, thanks. And then... okay, alright. Awesome. So, I believe there's only one fight here, but I'm not positive. I'm pretty sure there was only one. Have you heard? prototype XD-001's final adjustments are being behind schedule at headquarters. If they can get Crane to give up details about his purification study, all XD-001's problems should be solved in one fell swoop. I think so too, but he sounds quite obstinate and tight-lipped about the whole thing. I heard Lavrina's getting incensed over this. What? A kid in the lab? Hold still so we can catch you, kid. Cause that's something a kid's really gonna do. Sorry, but have you heard of Stranger Danger? No, thank you. Especially if you're gonna throw a Pokemon at me. I'm just gonna throw my Pokemon right back at you and mess you up. Oh god, why not? Why not? Yeah, it's why not. Don't know why I pronounced it the way I did, but whatever. So Shadow Blitz on Why Not. Rock Tomb on Swablu. Yep, there it is. There it is. Wow, that's a lot of damage against Numel. With a flying type move, really? Why not's gonna be a pain in the butt. Safeguard. Covered by a veil. So I think that drops special attack damage. Too bad all my attacks are physical attack damage. Well, at least the ones I'm trying to use. Though that really doesn't do a whole lot of damage. Oh, jeez. Then again, I gotta remember, Baltoy is more of a defensive mon. He's not so much a offensive. And I think that did less damage than it did before. Oh, and that's counter. And that's not good. Numel is hurt. Alright. I'm swapping out Numel for Umbreon just so that I can... Are you kidding me? Alright, fine. Let's do Dig on Why Not then. At least then it'll be Stab and it might actually do some damage. Do Rock Tomb on Swablu. And Why Not will be stuck doing nothing for a minute. Oh! That did a lot more damage than before. What's up with that? And my screen is absolutely wigging out. Not so sure what's going on there. Counter, but it failed. Alright, so Rock Tomb should take out Swablu. There we go. And Corsola, oh yay. And Dig! Does quite a bit of damage, but then Why Not's gonna go ahead and counter, and that's gonna be... Oh, really? Really? I suppose this is a perfect example of AI's stupidity, but I'll take it. We'll go ahead and use Dig on Why Not again, and that'll take care of that. And then I can use Psybeam on Corsola. And that should be able to do some damage to it. Unless that was, I don't know. Dug a hole, bubble, missed, but it's a, yeah. It's a wide range attack, so it attacks both opponents on the opposite side. It doesn't do too much to Baltoy. Mirror Coat, but it failed. Safeguard, faded. Alright. Now my special attack should be able to do more damage. I should have used Mud Slap, but oh well, whatever. Let's see if this does. I think a little more? Not a lot. And Numel at 5 points of health. Aww, really? Really, why not? And of course it would reverse mode. Oh boy. Alright, what do you got for me there, why not? Safeguard. Okay. That works. Oof. Don't do that. Alright. Yeah, let's call it. Hopefully Psybeam can take out Corsola, and then I don't have to worry about it, but... There we go. Nice! Good going, Baltoy! Alright, so Corsola's down. Why not? Can't really do anything. Alright, Ember. Let's do Shadow Blitz and Mud Slap. This is going to be it for Baltoy. Thankfully, it doesn't have Destiny Bonds, so it's not going to take anything with it. And 75 points of experience. Yay. Awesome. That was a longer fight than I expected, to be honestly. Beaten by a kid? Yes. Because you used crap tactics. And then couldn't even use those tactics properly. Had you used them properly, you probably could have at least taken out Nummel. But you continue to focus on him with the wrong stuff. After the first couple did so well. I'm busy. I'll let you go today, so go home without any fuss, okay? I'm not good at battling, but now's not the time to be telling you that. It is a dub. That's just back-to-back battles. I do not like those. Dustox and Wingull. Alright. Wingull's gonna be a slight problem, but Nummel is seriously hurt. However, I think I can at least get rid of Dustox with Ember. And I can use... Oh, no. Seriously? I just had to do it here of all places, right after the... This is what I have to freaking deal with when it comes to this stuff not wanting to work with me. It's annoying, because now, not only do I have to go back and redo that last fight, now I have to do it and hope that this turns out better than it did last time. This is annoying. Alright, so... Alright, I'll hop in, try and clear that two-pronged attack, and I was gonna say, let's deal with that two-pronged attack. Hopefully I can clear them both without the game crashing, and then I'm calling it good. I'm saving, and I'm calling it the end of the episode with that. I just want to get this done. Now, do I want to change my setup? No, I don't think I do. I only say that because I think... No. Swap out Umbreon for Baltoy. This is technically third gen, so... All dark moves are considered special attack, and I think Umbreon's special attack is its better... Oh, no, actually special and physical are not too far apart, so... Alright, that's something, but... Yeah, I think Umbreon might do me better in these next couple of fights. So, Baltoy's gonna have to hang back. Nummel was... Yeah, let's swap out for Mareep. Mareep's just about done, but with this, hopefully... Let's go ahead and save here. hopefully, if I beat this and then go through that elevator in the back there, I'll have a quick way of getting to a heal spot and getting out of here. So, let's go ahead and skip all the dialogue, because I don't want to deal with this crap. If I could make save states, I would, but I'm not sure on how to do that on this, so we'll have to hold off and see. So this time around, I'm going to go with Maryp and Umbreon. Hopefully that allows me some wiggle room. So we'll do Thundershock on Swablu and Bite on Wynot. Since Wynot's going to be going with Safeguard, apparently that's a negative priority move, so it's absolutely going to go last. So I can do some serious damage to it and then take it out next turn without having to worry about a counter. Actually, would counter work on Bite, or would that need mirror? Oh, okay. So Bite's already considered a physical move. Okay. That works, I guess. So Thundershock and Bite. Yeah, this is already going way better than last time, and much quicker too, thankfully. So yeah, these two should be able to get through this relatively quick. This is the one benefit I think I can see from the game crashing like it does. It gives me a look at how the battle is going to go the way that I usually would have it set up, or the way that I had it set up before. And then I can account for that and fix it. Because this is already going much better than the last run was going. Oh, okay then. Hi. Doesn't exactly happen very often, but it's good to see. Yeah, it's not going to do a whole lot of damage to either one of them, really. I'm surprised you did 2 points of damage to Umbreon. Alright. The nice thing about the reverse mode's recoil damage is only 1 point. It's not going to do anything real major, thankfully. Alright. Call Maryp. And it's already just about done. My gosh. Alrighty then. Mary just wants to be purified here and now. And knowing my luck, it might actually be ready after the next battle, so. Elrock, huh? Beaten by a kid. Yep. Again, faster this time. Yeah, I don't care what you guys have to say. I just want to get this battle done so that I can save and be good. Yeah, hi Dustox, hi Wingull. This is the one problem with not having Numel. I don't have something to deal with Dustox quite right, but that's alright. Wingull shouldn't last a Thundershock. It really shouldn't. If it does, I'll be impressed, honestly. Oh, unless it decides to confuse it first. Yep, okay. Well, so much for that. Alright. Yeah, Dustox has a high special defense, so it's not really gonna do a whole lot of damage. Gust ain't gonna do crap. Come on, Maryp. Yeah! There we go. And Thundershock. And that's a done Wingull. There we go.
So now Pineco. I swear to God, if you blow up. Let's focus on Dustox just because I want to get it out of the way. I don't really have anything for either of these Pokemon, so... Well, that's only really going to be effective on Mareep. Umbreon is immune to Psychic, so... It's pretty obvious where he was going with that. Come on. Nice! Alright. I think I'm done hoping that Confusion doesn't... Of course. You would end up having a Quillfish. Alright. Pineco uses Tackle, does a good chunk on Mareep. Yay. Ah! Paralyzed. Eat that. Alright, so one last Thundershock on Quillfish. I'm not expecting it to actually hit because Confusion hasn't even caused it to hit itself in Confusion yet, so I'm not gonna push my luck with hoping for that. Yeah, you can't really do anything to my Pokemon, so. Really? Alright, Mary. MVP of this battle, holy crap. Just doesn't want to hit itself. That's awesome. Alright. I was a little over hopeful with it taking out Quillfish, but that's fine. With this round, if things go the way they should, I should be able to take out both of them this round. And that'll be the end of this fight. And Poison Sting, yay. That didn't do crap. Wow, Mary, holy crap. 4 turns confused, didn't hit yourself once. I will take it. That is some of the best confusion luck I've ever had. That was phenomenal. Good going, Mary. You deserve all the praise this time around. Absolute MVP of this fight. Nope, I'm just no good at battling. Honestly, he lost because of bad hacks. Honestly, that was awesome. I'm pretending that I never saw you. Scram already. Yeah, okay, let me grab the chest real quick. A great ball, yay. That might actually be helpful. Oh, and Mareep is now ready to be purified. Cool. I'll go ahead and switch my team back up. You know, return the team to its original setup. Go right over here. Save. Because I really don't want to have to go through that fight again. It took 8 minutes to go through that. Alright. And that'll do it for me here, you guys. So, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I have to give my props to Mary. He absolutely pulled through that last fight, but, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye.